Racing to the 2024 Kentucky Derby, and this time, let's get an update on the Kentucky Derby leaderboard after the Jerome Stakes on Saturday at Aqueduct. We also had a prep out west, the San Vincente at 7 furlongs, and starting off, we'll take a look at the Jerome Stakes. We'll also take a look at a couple of recent winners, an allowance winner at Gulfstream Park, and a maiden winner first out at Tampa Bay. The Jerome Stakes came in with a field of 5. Drum roll please, was even money on the morning line, ended up going off at 3-5. Meanwhile, Canate was 9-1, and Regalo was bet down to 3-1 odds in the Jerome. Small field, but some mighty runners with drum roll please, 3rd in the Remsen Stakes, and Regalo a nice win last out at Laurel. Let's go to the start of this race. Now, it was pretty much a clean start for everybody. If you haven't watched the trip handicapping video, this is a good start. And on the inside, drum roll please, breaks well, but then the jockey elects to go to the back of the pack at the rail. So he broke good, and he's in last place early. Drum roll please, the one horse in the Jerome Stakes. Now, when you take a look at this field coming into the stretch run, you've got drum roll please. He's going to go wide. That's where they decide to tip out. Javier Castellano rides. Brad Cox, the trainer. Hard spun the sire. And he is a Pennsylvania bred. Of course, drum roll please. Now with a couple of wins in New York and the connections of Cyberknife, the owner of this race. Of course, Cyberknife won the Arkansas Derby a couple of years ago, trained by Brad Cox for the owner of drum roll please. Let's take a look. 10 points for drum roll please. He's a big horse. Nice gallop out. Let's look at him in the post races. He goes to the winner's circle. Look at the shiny coat. Really seems to be well developed physically, a lot of muscle on drum roll please. A nice win. Of course, a lot of runners from the Jerome Stakes don't make it to the Kentucky Derby. A little bit a lesser race prep wise, but it did look like a good prep for him to get ready for the Wither Stakes on February 3rd. Let's go now to Gulfstream Park. Friday, an allowance race. Big favorite in the race was Change of Command. He had broke his maiden a couple of weeks ago. Again, let's go to the start of the race. It is a clean start for everybody. Change of Command is the three horse wearing the blue silks. Gets out good. He's in the middle of the track. Got boxed in just a little bit early, but he broke well in this race. So Change of Command goes into that first turn with a good trip. Now let's pick it up on the stretch run. Change of Command battling for the lead here. He's on the outside. The inside horse of Todd Pletcher kind of coming back at him a couple of times. A fight to the finish. Should be a good conditioning race for Change of Command. Of course, he is by Into Mischief, and he's picked up back-to-back wins after losing to Sierra Leone in a nice race at Aqueduct in the fall. Change of Command, maybe the Fountain of Youth, maybe the Holy Bull Stakes. Let's see where Bill Mott goes with him next. Tampa Bay Downs on Friday, a heavily bet favorite, a first-time starter by the name of Aries Magic. The sire is Good Magic, and here's his debut race. Got a little bit behind the field early at 6 furlongs, comes around the turn. He's a 7 horse here, down the lane, straight and strong, really strides out. Finished with a good time, and he was the bet down to favoritism off a series of strong works coming into this race. Aries Magic, a $725,000 sales price for the son of Good Magic. Could maybe see him in the Sam F. Davis, maybe the Tampa Bay Derby down the road. Christophe LeCament, the trainer. Now let's go out west. We've got the San Vincente Stakes. It's not a points race. It's 7 furlongs. Muth is 4-5. Pilot Commander is 2-5. Both of them trained by Bob Baffert. Let's look at the start of this race. Coming out of the gate early was Slider, the 2 horse. He takes the lead on the inside. Right to the outside of him is Pilot Commander, the 4 horse. Sitting in that garden spot, the catbird seat, is Muth, the number 3 horse. Now let's pick it up going into the stretch. Of course, by this time, they start to back out. You've got the 2 runners from Bob Baffert's barn, Muth and Pilot Commander, engaging for the lead. Pilot Commander takes a brief lead, but bounding away late is the big strapping son of Good Magic. His name is Muth. He picks up the win, and Muth powers away to victory in the San Vincente. Of course, trainer is Bob Baffert. Muth, he has now won the American Pharoah Stakes, San Vincente Stakes, and he placed in the Breeders' Cup Juvenile behind Fierceness. And of course, Fierceness will be making his debut in a couple of weeks. So some good races overall. Next races are starting to come out. for some of the big name runners and leaders on the Kentucky Derby leaderboard. Fierceness continues to work out in Florida. He is pointing for the Holy Bull on February 3rd. Honest Marie had a workout. Looks like he's going to go to the Risen Star Stakes. Catching Freedom, the Smarty Jones Stakes winner. Looks like we could see him in either the Risen Star Stakes or possibly the long-term goal is the Arkansas Derby. Locked, another one trained by Todd Pletcher. He's going to the Tampa Bay Derby most likely. Maybe the Sam F. Davis, we'll see. Nisos, to be determined. He's been working out for trainer Bob Baffert. No race yet. Could be the Robert Lewis Stakes. And then Intricate, a three-year-old filly, going to be pointing for the Rachel Alexandra Stakes as she came out of her last race well. And we're starting to line them up now as we get to the second week in January. The road to the 150th running of the Kentucky Derby continues. We've got the Santa Ana Stakes preview. That is up on the channel. The Bassanda Stakes next week from Aqueduct. LeCompte Stakes on January 20th. Then we get to the big separation Saturday. You've got the Withers Stakes February 3rd, the Robert Lewis Stakes, and the Holy Bull Stakes. That's going to be part of that February 3rd of racing. Don't forget the trip handicapping video is out. You can watch that on the channel. And we continue along with more coverage. The Triple Crown Prospectus, free every Monday, 2,000 words. Sign up in the description below as we write about the three-year-old fillies, the three-year-old colts, all the way through the Belmont Stakes. It's free. Sign up. And what did you think of the Jerome Stakes? What did you think of Muth? Leave a comment and any other horses you want to see profiled. As D. Wayne Lucas always says, people have opinions, horses have the facts.